Jigoro Kano Shihan performs the Koshiki no Kata with Yoshitsugu Yamashita, 10th Dan. The Koshiki no Kata are largely based on the kata of the Kitoryu of Jiu-Jitsu, which Jigoro Kano Shihan studied before founding Kodokan Judo. Jigoro Kano Shihan realized that the kata of Kitoryu were superior in both theory and technique, and were the most appropriate and effective means of cultivating the right spirit. He therefore introduced them as the Koshiki no Kata. The Koshiki no Kata are based on the nagewaza, or throwing techniques, executed by samurai in armor on the battlefield. They consist of 14 omote and 7 ura forms. Let's look at the Koshiki no Kata performed in succession. Notice the overall flow of the kata. Omote, the first, tie. The second, Yume no Uchi. The third, Ryokuhi. The fourth, Mizuguruma. The fifth, Mizunagare. The sixth, Hikiotoshi. The seventh, Kodaore. The eighth, Uchikudaki. The ninth, Taniotoshi. The 10th, Kuruma Daore. The 11th, Shikorodori. The 12th, Shikorogaishi. The 13th, Yudachi. The 14th, Takiotoshi. And now let's watch the seven Ura forms. The Ura forms are performed quickly and boldly, demonstrating the essence of attack and defense in judo. And now let's look at the techniques involved in the kata. To begin, the opponents stand facing front and bow. They then face each other, standing 5 meters apart, kneel and bow. The kneeling salutation is performed on the assumption that you're wearing armor. It's therefore different from an ordinary bow. Stand with your feet slightly apart, kneel on one leg after the other, and bow. Keep the tips of your toes upright on the floor. Rise from the kneeling position, one leg after the other. After bowing, both opponents take one step forward and assume natural fundamental posture. The tori turns right and takes 2 steps forward. Calming his mind, he takes another step forward and assumes natural fundamental posture. The uke approaches the tori's left from behind and begins the first form, tai. The uke grabs the tori's belt with both hands, pulls and tries to throw him. The tori, however, hugs the uke's hips from behind and places his right hand on the uke's left chest to push and break the uke's balance, throwing him over his left knee. Watch the tori's hands. Notice the feet of both opponents. And now let's look at the ukemi. The tori pushes and breaks the uke's balance, throwing him across his left knee. The uke spreads his left leg out wide, brings his right foot towards his left, and avoids the tori's left knee. He then spreads his left leg out again in ukemi. On completing ukemi, the uke's legs are spread out wide. After throwing the uke, the tori opens his left leg to the left and assumes the kurai dori position. And now let's watch the transition from tai to the second form, yume no uchi. As in the previous technique, tai, the tori tries to throw the uke by pushing and breaking his balance. Using the uke's resistance to break his balance to the fore, the tori leans back and throws himself backward. The tori restrains the uke's upper body and pushes him back. The uke holds his ground and pushes back. Using the uke's resistance, the tori leans back to break the uke's balance. At the same time, he places his right hand on the uke's upper arm and faces him. Notice how the tori uses his left hand. The tori's feet are on the right-hand side of the uke's feet. Let's look at the action from behind. The uke is thrown diagonally over the tori's body and comes to his feet. Upon throwing the uke, the tori spreads his arms and legs out wide. This nagawaza is called yoko wakare and is a randori waza of Kodokan Judo. And now, watch how the second form, Yume no Uchi, is followed by the third, Ryokuhi. The uke tries to grab the front of the tori's belt with both hands. The tori steps back with his right foot and turns his body to the right, pulling the uke towards him. He then places his hands on the uke's shoulders and throws him directly behind. Watch the tori's hands. Let's look at the action from the other side. In ryokuhi, the tori throws the uke in one breath. The tori is on the left-hand side. Watch his right foot carefully. The uke swings his right foot out and strikes the mat with his right hand in ukemi. And now from the third form, ryokuhi, to the fourth, mizuguruma. The tori grabs the uke's right hand and tries to throw him forward. Using the uke's resistance, the tori pushes the uke and breaks his balance to the rear. As the uke resists, the tori falls back and throws him over, just as in Yume no Uchi. The tori grabs the uke's wrist and pushes the back of his hand up to his forehead, while at the same time pressing the small of the uke's back and breaking the uke's balance to the rear. Using the uke's resistance, the tori pulls forward and upsets the uke's balance. Notice the feet movement of the tori on the right-hand side. Let's look at the ukemi. The uke slaps the mat with his right hand just above the tori's left shoulder and falls diagonally over the tori in ukemi. And now going from the fourth form, mizuguruma, to the fifth, mizunagare. After finishing Mizuguruma, the Tori and Uke take up the following positions to begin Mizunagare. They stand diagonally about 5 meters apart. The Uke goes for the Tori's chest with an imaginary dagger. At that very moment, the Tori grabs the Uke's left hand, pulls, and throws him. The Uke advances towards the Tori, reaching out with his left hand. The Tori grabs the Uke's wrist with his right hand, thumb on top, and with his left hand pushes the Uke's arm up to break his balance. The Tori grabs the inside of the Uke's upper left arm with his left hand, thumb down, drops to his right knee, and throws the Uke by pulling. The Uke is holding an imaginary dagger with his right hand. Notice how the Tori reverses the hold of his left hand. As soon as the Tori grabs the Uke's left wrist, he steps back in Sugiyashi to pull and break the Uke's balance. He then drops to his right knee and throws the Uke over. The Uke rolls over, sits up, and spreads his legs. And now from the fifth form, Mizunagare, to the sixth, Hikiotoshi. Notice the Tori's timing in throwing the Uke. The Uke grabs for the Tori's belt with his right hand. This is when the Tori grabs the Uke's right arm and throws him. Let's look at the action from a different angle. The Tori drops to his left knee and throws the Uke by pulling. The Uke falls and sits up with his legs spread out. And now from the sixth form, Hikiotoshi, to the seventh, Kodaori. The Tori attempts to strike the Uke's temple. The Uke evades the strike and tries to apply a koshinage. The Tori presses his right arm against the Uke's face, breaks his balance and throws him. The Tori moves forward, raising his right arm. He strikes at the Uke's temple and attempts to overpower him. The Tori presses his right arm against the Uke's face and his left hand against the front of the Uke's belt. The Tori advances in Sugiyashi and breaks the Uke's balance to the rear. After throwing the Uke, the Tori moves his right knee out to the right and assumes the Kurai Dori position. And now from the seventh form, Kodaori, to the eighth, Uchigudaki. The tori moves towards the uke, aiming at his abdomen. The uke avoids the attack and tries to apply a koshinage, but the tori grabs him from the front, lifts and throws him. The tori moves his left knee out to the left and assumes the kurai dori position. The tori's right hand is pressed against the front of the uke's belt. The uke's body is bent backwards. And now from the eighth form, uchikudaki, to the ninth, taniotoshi. The tori and uke take up the following positions to begin taniotoshi. The uke stands about 3 meters behind the tori to his left. They both stand in natural fundamental posture. The uke tries to push the tori down by pressing his right hand against the tori's right shoulder and left hand against the abdomen. Without resisting, the tori bends forward. He then traps the uke's body, pulls him up and throws him backwards. Watch the tori's right hand. He grabs the fingers of the uke's right hand, thumb down. After throwing the uke, the tori moves his left knee out to the left in kurai dori. And now going from the ninth form, taniotoshi, to the tenth, kuruma daore. The uke approaches the tori from behind and tries to twist him down with both hands. Without resisting, the tori pivots and faces the uke, pulls him up, and by throwing his own body backward, throws the uke over his head.